everyone. Here we are at Vancouver Community College's Broadway campus on a beautiful autumn day. We are so fortunate that today we are going to be speaking with Mr. Ajay Patel, the president of Vancouver Community College. So, let's go. How are you doing, Mr. Patel? It's a pleasure to see you.
Oh, good morning, and I'm doing really well, thank you. Welcome to Vancouver Community College and our Broadway campuses. We're on the traditional unceded territory, the Musqueam, Squamish, and Tsleil-Waututh peoples.
Thank you so much. Thank you for that wonderful welcome. We're so glad to be here with you today.
Pleasure.
Now, Mr. Patel, would you be able to tell us how long have you been the president of Vancouver Community College?
I've had the privilege of serving as the president here for the last 2.5 years, and prior to that I was a vice president here as well.
We've learned that your programs for January, May, and September are already full to international students. How did that come about?
Our programs are very popular here with international students, particularly our hospitality and culinary programs, our auto programs, and the reason those are all popular, all those programs provide hands-on training for students, which lead to very good, well-paying jobs for people that want to stay back here and become immigrants. The programs are also small class sizes. They get a lot of applied learning. For example, in our culinary programs, they're in the industrial kitchens that they would work at in downtown hotels or in large facilities like convention centers. Our auto programs all have garages where the students can come in and do a lot of hands-on training. And with hospitality programs, there's some in-classroom learning, and then students actually get to go out and get a work experience. And so those collectively combined give students a whole breadth of experiences that they really enjoy, that they have a good time with. We have wonderful instructors, but at the end of the day, it serves the student well because that can help get the job that they're looking for and pursue the career they want, or maybe in some cases, ongoing learning opportunities for them in degree pursuits or other education.
That's great. Hands-on learning is such a wonderful opportunity. It's excellent that the students here have that opportunity.
Yeah, we're very lucky that way. And it's one of the central ways of learning for this institution. We've always been about applied learning, hands-on learning, also meeting labor market demands in the region and for the province and in some cases the country. For example, the auto program is the largest in the province of British Columbia, where we have our auto collision, our refinishing, and our technician programs. And the students come from all over the world to participate in the program, and many of them stay back here, or some go back to their home countries. And that's just one example of how we're able to meet some of the demands of students. And therefore, we always have wait lists, and I wish I had bigger shops or more shops where we can accommodate students, but we have capacity limitations because of the hands-on learning ratios.
International student enrollment has increased so much. How did you make this happen?
First of all, it takes a team to make things happen, so a lot of credit goes to our international education team and the programs that we provide and the student service and supports that we do. So we're really proud of that, but also we're thankful for agent partners that we have, like FSS, that help us get those students to where they need to go, but so that we better understand the needs of the student to meet student demands. So that's one of the key reasons is the team. But the other reason is, or other reasons are, the program that we provide is relevant programming, programming that interests the students. And finally, the whole student service piece, just similar to how FSS serves their students, our Vancouver Community College students, international student team, serves all of our students. We have a case management approach where there are high touch points with the students. We've maintained communication with the students, let them know where they are along the step through their application process, and even once they've been accepted, how they can register. And then we support them when they're here through our international student coordinators. We try and integrate them into the community college, as well as the opportunity to help them along when they do encounter some of the challenges and barriers, as any student would.
The programs here at Vancouver Community College are in such high demand with international students. Because of that, do you intend to, in the future, open up any more spaces for international students here?
We're very proud of the number of international students we already have on our programs here, but we are always looking to increase the type of programming that we offer that's relevant, and that's important for international students, but also meets demands of our region. So right now we do have program space in our post-degree diplomas for marketing, for accounting, but we are looking at opening up new programs in opticianary and other programming as we see needs and that we have the capacity to grow. What we want to make sure is that we have quality programs that are high in demand, that are relevant to students, and will get them to where they need to go in their educational journey, whether they're domestic or they're international students. So that's how we determine the expansion of programs. So I would anticipate that you'll see more programs for international students opening up in the near future here at Vancouver Community College.
So are there any scholarships available to international students here at VCC?
Yeah, all students have access to all scholarships here, whether they're domestic or international students here at VCC. And international students will usually go through the International Education Department to talk to the student coordinators that are there and find out what scholarships they're eligible for. But the scholarships are available to all students, and many of our international students do receive financial support through those scholarships.
What the future goals are for Vancouver Community College's international student programs?
As we're starting to come out of this pandemic, we know economic recovery is critical, not just for Vancouver and British Columbia and Canada, but for the whole world. And so our graduates have always been part of building community around us. Our hospitality grads help with the tourism sector. Our culinary students help with the hospitality and the food industry. Our auto students help with the auto tech and technician sector. So we anticipate that there'll be more and more increased demand for those programs. And so as we come out of the pandemic, we will be looking to see how we can help retrain those that need to be trained, but also provide opportunities for students to get new training here at VCC in those areas and to help the economic recovery and rebuild the region as we come out of the pandemic.
What the current population of international students here at VCC is, and what are your current plans for growth and development in the future?
Well, currently we have about 2,000 international students from 50 different countries studying, so we're very proud of that.
Amazing.
And the multicultural and the different types of backgrounds they all come from, and the richness of learning environment that they create for all of our students. In terms of growth, we are coming out of a pandemic. We know our provincial government is going to come up with a new international education framework, and we are looking forward to that framework. The future growth, I think, will be dictated by the labor market demands, and so we're very fortunate at VCC. We have programs that will meet those labor market demands, and so as we see the need for those labor market demands, we will try and grow programming in those areas, and those will be really attractive to international students. I see growth in the hospitality sector as our tourism industry recovers. I see growth in our culinary sector as well, as food is a real real passion of Vancouverites and British Columbians. And with the adoption of the clean energy, as we go through the electrification of cars to hydrogenic vehicles, we're going to need different technicians. We're going to need new technicians as we evolve the auto industry. So you'll see program growths in all of those areas, and the growth will include international and domestic students.
Mr. Patel, as one of the leaders in international education in Canada, are you able to tell us a little bit more about how you got here, your journey, what skills and successes someone like you needs to come into a position like this?
I actually started my education and got my diploma on what was the Vancouver Community College Langara campus of the day, and I got my diploma there. I went on to UBC and finished my degree and also my master's degree. I think the key to it is just my passion for lifelong learning, wanting to learn different skills, wanting to learn different things, different techniques, but also the opportunity to contribute back. And now I have an opportunity to serve in a community and help students that will eventually help society. So I think that's really my driving passion. And I encourage any student to remain lifelong learners. Be curious about what you want to do. Follow your passions, follow your dreams, but don't close any doors either.
Wonderfully stated. Thank you. That was some excellent insight you provided us with. And of course, the encouragement to always remain lifelong learners is so valuable for all students currently in college, applying to college, and just citizens of the world.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Mr. Patel, and sharing some insight about the wonderful programs here at Vancouver Community College for international students. It has been so insightful, and we are so grateful for your time. Thank you so much.
It was my pleasure. Thank you very much as well.
Thank you so much for joining us here at Canada International Student Magazine. And be sure to tune in for more information for international students here in Canada.